Queen BBQ.
Yeah, does this be Queen BBQ?
Yes, it is.
See, man, I want to place it out. We having a big gospel sing over here, I think.
Yeah.
And man, we need to get some barbecue to go.
All right, you cut it right. Yeah, you cut it right, please.
Okay, see, man, look out. Let me just tell you my order and we can pick it up.
Okay, I need your name.
Break.
Uh-huh.
B-Y-K-E.
All right.
Yeah. And look out. All right. I'm going to need 2 dozen wangs.
2 dozen wangs, all right.
Yeah, and, with some light bread.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, some light bread.
See, man, look out. What is it, Leona?
So what?
Man, baby, don't be yelling at me.
Oh, man, say, why do you dude here? Calling me up their man? I got work to do.
Yeah,
man,
all right. Wait a minute. Wait a minute, man. What you mean? All right.
Oh, yeah. Man.
All right.
I don't know what
yeah, work with. I said 2 dozen wangs.
Yeah, I got that.
And look here. They want some rib, too, man.
All right.
Full or rib.
Full or rib.
Yeah. And one chop beef sandwich.
One chop beef.
Yeah. And, I don't know. I guess I'd give us eight peppers.
Eight peppers.
Right? All right. And, that'll do it for now.
All right, sir.
Yeah.
So you finna enjoy some jam and some good barbecue.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right, man.
Yeah. Enjoy yourself, man.
Yeah,
enjoy
goodbye,
yourself.
Man.
All right.
Yeah, I gotta have my intro.
Yeah, man. Man, play the band intro, too. In Kenneth, Texas, just on 45. It's a happening little place. It's a buzzing like a hive. It ain't like no other place that you've ever seen, 'cause they feed you like a king, and it's owned by the queen. Queen bee, queen bee. Oh man, sure is some fine barbecue. Keep on the dark side of the track, but don't make no never mind. When you need some barbecue, it's the only place to dine. They got chopped beef sandwich on some thin sliced bread. And when you got to have it, man, just remember what I said. Queen bee, queen bee. Ooh, it sure is some fine barbecue. They got the lunch plate special for a poor man price. Potato salad, red bean, and your tea on ice. They got a red hot pepper, and I tell you no lie, they serve a rib so tender, make a grown man cry. Queen bee, queen bee, yeah. This sure is some fine barbecue. They got some barbecue chicken, you just gotta try. With some Louisiana hot sauce on a tender short time. And a red soda of water served in a striped cup. They got a drive-thru window, so pull right on up. It's Queen Bee. Yes, it is. Queen Bee. Ooh, it sure is some fine barbecue. Between Dallas, Houston, on a southbound 45. It's a poppin' and a jumpin' like a buzzin' little hive. You can smell that barbecue over mesquite wood. Oh, man, Queen Bee barbecue. Mmm, so good. Queen Bee. Yeah, Queen Bee. Sure is some fine barbecue.
Good morning, this is KBBQ. This segment of our program is brought to you by Queen Bee BBQ, now serving breakfast. Drop by this morning on your way to work and try their new grits on a stick. And they still serve that fine-tasting barbecue. So good. I am Maurice Superfly Johnson.
Yeah, Cleo is here. I was just looking in the paper here, man. And
mm-hmm.
I see that one of my favorite TV shows going to be on TV tonight.
One of your favorite TV shows. What is that, man?
The Harlem Globetrotters on Gilligan's Island.
Mm-hmm.
It's a good one, man.
Is that a comedy or a drama?
It's a documentary.
A documentary, you say. Mm-hmm. Hey. KBBQ.
Cleone's with ya.
And Marie Superfly Johnson, I got some good news and some bad news if you wears glasses. A new survey say we thinks that glasses makes people look more intelligent and more mature. And the bad news is that we also think people with glasses looks less sexy. You know, they lose their sex appeal.
Yeah, man, I'll tell you what's even less sexier than that.
What is that, man?
It's some of a woman on her hands and knees with one eye open looking for a contact lens.
Yeah, that's right.
Now, here's a story about a great big old giant who, my money, my honey, and me. I've been digging all the stories about the West the cats had told. Me and my baby cut out there, dig us up a mess of gold. The minute we found a buried treasure, I looked up to see a great big old 8-foot giant looking dead on me. And that dude, you know, and that dude.
Marie Superfly Johnson, and I got a little public service announcement for you. If you're trying to find that perfect gift for the person who has everything, you may want to adopt a humpback whale. For only $15, each adoptive parent receives a certificate, the name of your foster whale, and a photo. This wonderful idea comes to us from the International Wildlife Coalition. For more information, get in touch with the folks at the International Wildlife Coalition.
Yeah, man, it'd be my luck I'd get one of those suicidal whales that keep trying to beach itself to draw attention to third world hunger or something like that, you know. I could just see my picture of my foster whale dead on the beach and a note from the International Wildlife Coalition say, "Here's your whale, Cleotis. We tried to get there sooner, man, but we didn't make it. Sorry, you're going to have to deal with it, you know." That's the kind of luck I got.
Sammich.
Oh, that's what I dig. Man, I need a cool Weenie Sammich. Make me flip my wig.
Ooh, I don't need no microwave for the dish I crave. Need a cool Weenie Sammich.
Man, thin sliced bread. Little man, he's a relish. Go plug to my head. Come on, baby, don't be no meanie. I need a
cold weenie. Look out now, little man. Cold weenie sandwich.
Yeah, it sure hit a spot now.
Like a cold weenie sandwich.
Ooh, I just can't
dig them hot now.
Ooh, the redder the better.
Cold weenie sandwich.
Hey, baby, look here. Get him one of them real sandwiches there.
I guess you're gonna need some extra barbecue sauce for that, ain't you?
Do what? Yeah, sir, and put me some napkins in there, too, and put me a toothpick in there.
Say, man, do this sound familiar to you? I know it do. Because you think it's Queen Bee Barbecue, but Sammy, look here. Look, there's a brand new place across the street from Queen Bee. It's called the Rib Crib. Excuse me, man, look here.
Where you get on my jacket?
I can tell you a barbecue man from way back yonder.
Uh-huh.
You know how come I know that?
No, how come you can tell that?
Because I see some of that dried barbecue barbecue sauce all over your mouth.
Yeah, that's right. And I was gonna stop at Queen Bee till I see the sign out front here to see. Three-quarter malt liquor with every rib sandwich order with a rib crib.
So you likes the rib crib?
Look here, I like sucking down a three-quarter beer, okay? But I also like that rib sandwich. But them bones hurt my teeth.
Mm-hmm, I know, that's right.
Say, man, loan me $20.
Do what? Say, man, look here, I only got $10.
Well, then loan me $10 and then owe me $10.
Do what? Man, you know you was my dude. Remember, when you tired of Queen Bee, come on over to the rib crib.
And remember, a three-quarter malt liquor with the purchase of a rib sandwich from the rib crib. And if you ask this fool for some money, you can get your sandwich for free.
You know you're tired of Queen Bee, so don't fib. Next time you hungry, come to the rib crib.
Man, do you see the legs on that chick?
Mm-hmm. Sure did, man. You know I like to have me them legs with a side of mashed potatoes, some collard greens. Ooh, I mean right now, man. Right now.
Ooh, I know. That's right.
What do these people be talking about? They ran and raving over the new rib crib sensation. Legs, legs, and more legs. The rib crib now offer legs in a basket. Tiny little chicken legs dressed up in little mesquite-flavored pantyhose. Mmm, chicken legs in a basket. Man, it make your wife get jealous.
Ooh, you ain't finna put your mouth on them legs. Ain't no leg sucking going on at this table, baby. Mm-mm.
See what I mean? So take your little wife out tonight for some serious chicken that has a bite at the rib crib. Mmm, it's better than Queen Bee.